गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वी कैन सी चैप्टर वन, इंट्रोडक्शन टू मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स. इंट्रोडक्शन. देर आर टू मेजर ब्रांचेस ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स, नेमली माइक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स एंड मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स. माइक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स मीन्स इकोनॉमिक्स ऑफ स्मॉल. एज द नेम सजेस्ट, माइक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स टेक्स माइक्रोस्कोपिक व्यू ऑफ द इकोनॉमी. It is like dealing with individual trees in the economic forest. It is the study of particular firm, particular household, individual price, wage, income, industry, and particular commodity. It explains how prices of wheat, cloth, shoes, pens, and thousands of other goods are determined. Similarly, how prices of factors of production are determined. What are the factors of production? Land, labor, capital, and organization. How the prices of these factors of production are determined. Since prices of products and factors occupy the central place, microeconomics is therefore also called price theory. So far, we have studied introductory microeconomics, and now we shall start with introductory macroeconomics. Briefly, microeconomics is the study of behavior of individual economic units of the economy, whereas macroeconomics is the study of behavior of economy as a whole and its aggregates. For example, the study of a forest as a whole, the study of a human body as a whole, national income, total employment, aggregate savings and investment, aggregate demand, aggregate supply, etc. Here we study how these aggregates and averages of the economy as a whole are determined, and what causes fluctuations in them. Since the subject matter of macroeconomics revolves around determination of the level of income and employment, therefore it is also known as theory of income and employment. The words micro and macro was coined up in 1933 by a Norwegian economist Ragnar Anton Kittelfrisch, who got the first Nobel Prize in Economic Sciences in the year 1969. The well-known British economist J.M. Keynes propounded his own theory and wrote his famous book, General Theory of Employment, Interest and Money, published in 1936. Keynes criticized the classical assumption of full employment and developed a new theory known as macroeconomic theory. Thus, during Great Depression of 1929-33, strong desire to control business cycles in advanced economies and to develop backward economies became the main factors which have contributed to the development of modern macroeconomics. Hence, Keynes is regarded as the father of modern macroeconomics. Next one, subject matters of macroeconomics. They are employment, national income, inflation, business cycle, poverty, inequality, disparity, investment and saving, capital formation, infrastructure development, international trade, balance of trade and balance of payments, exchange rate and economic growth. All these we will study under this economic macroeconomics. Next, importance of macroeconomics. The importance and for introducing a macro of an economy are, first one, to solve the basic problems in an economy. the basic problems. What are the basic problems in the society? What are the basic problems? What to produce and in what quantities? Whether we have to produce food or weapons? If so, in what quantities? Is it more food and less weapons, or less food and more weapons? Second problems, how shall the goods be produced? We can produce the electricity from thermal power or from hydropower. Third one, for whom shall the goods be produced? The goods should be produced for rich or for poor. These are the three basic problems in the society. These problems are interdependent. So, to solve the basic problems prevailing in an economy, to understand the functioning of the economy, macroeconomics is important. Second importance of macroeconomics is future problems, needs, and challenges of an economy. To understand the future problems, needs, and challenges of an economy. At present, we don't know what is going on. What is the current situation? What are the problems and challenges we are facing now in the society? What are the problems, challenges? COVID-19. The economic and social disruption caused by the pandemic is devastating. Tens of millions of people are at risk of falling into extreme poverty. Unemployment rose from 6.7% to 26%. Financial crisis is other problem, etc. So all these are the economic problems that facing in our country now. We have to solve these problems. Steps should be taken to solve this crisis. So all these we can understand through macroeconomics. So it is very important. Third one, to understand the reality. Macroeconomics provides ample opportunities to use scientific investigation and to understand the reality. Next, to compare and analyze economic indicators. Economic indicators allow analysis of economic performance and predictions of future performance. One application of economic indicators is the study of business cycle. Economic indicators include GDP, consumer price index, inflation, etc. So macroeconomics helps to make meaningful comparison and analysis of economic indicators. Last one, to avoid economic crisis. Macroeconomics helps for better prediction about future and to formulate suitable policies to avoid economic crisis. So these are the importance of macroeconomics. So today we studied introduction of macroeconomics, branches of macroeconomics, meaning of macroeconomics, subject matter of macroeconomics, and importance of macroeconomics. Students, the same chapter will be continued in the next class.